Hey, we're talking to John J.R. Robinson again. I'm John Beaudin from Rocky Stream Music.
Let's go back to Greg Fillinganes, like the We Are the World thing. So that was basically you and Greg doing the basic track before.
And Lou and Lewis Johnson. Yeah, that was 1985. We were at Kenny Rogers Studio A, which used to be ABC Dunhill Records, which is where, when I joined Rufus, that's where we'd go. It was really kind of ironic. But I had started working and being the drummer for Kenny Rogers, so I knew exactly where I was going, and we'd go there all the time, or Lionel would go there, or whatever. So we went in there, and there's, you know, 50 media people in there, and this is a week before the vocalist came. And the vocalist came to A&M down the street, which is now Henson. It was an incredible story. We're in there hanging out with the piano and watching Mike and Lionel, you know, come up with this form, and, you know, messing around with Michael, and, you know, Michael realizes that his peers are all around him. And he was really cool. You know, me and Lewis are screwing around, and all of a sudden, Quincy looks at me from the control room, and he goes like this. Like, I am the damn sergeant. Like, he made me the damn sergeant. You know, I need a flat top. And so, in other words, all these media people were in the room, and you've probably heard this, but I'll say it exactly the way it went down. And I looked at everybody, and everybody's just... snap, 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 rack, rack, talk, talk. And I go, everybody, get the fuck out. What? I go, everybody, get out. Get out. Give us 15 minutes or 20 minutes and let us cut this song, and then you can come back in. Because what we need is, we don't need to hear any camera snaps. We don't need to hear any milling. We have to cut this thing quietly so then you guys have some more to report on. Okay, and there was like the Exodus, bam, door slam. So I looked at everybody, and then Quincy goes, okay, ready, here we go. Psh, click, click, click. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And we cut that song in probably one take, maybe two. And the song was like 6-7 minutes long. It took a long time. And then when it was over, I felt bad. I went out and I go, listen, I'm sorry. Oh, they all apologized to me. And I go, you guys can come on in. I should have said, where's the champagne, boys? But there wasn't any. And then that was it. That's the way it went down.
When did you know, hey, wait a minute, I can easily make a living at this. Like, I'm connected enough, I'm doing enough. How old were you and when was it? Because, man, you worked a lot of stuff.
Yeah, and still, I mean, I just finished 2 weeks with Josh Groban right now. All live streams for, oh God, we must have done 75 shows. So you're going to be seeing a lot of Josh Groban. And then, oh, there I am in a purple shirt. There I am in a black shirt. But he's such a great singer. So, yes, I'm still doing it. Knock on wood. When I was 10 and I had this 9-year-old guitar player named Kevin Clemens, and we'd sit in his bedroom and talk about music and put Sean, and what do you think of that? I go, wow, that's kind of cool. Let me play this one. And I right there, and when we started playing together, I knew that's what I wanted to do. So, we got our first gig when I was 10. I just kept getting paid, and it was a lot of fun. You know, then I decided to go to Berkeley and Boston. Ed Sof, actually, I studied with Ed in high school via jazz camps, and Ed didn't want me going to North Texas State. He goes, no, you need to go to Boston. He goes, Boston's going to have more variety for you, and you're going to fit in better there. And I go, okay. So I moved to Boston. There was then a time where I was going to New York, man. Back then, I can't work here anymore. I'm tired, and it's like music sucks. And so, but that didn't happen. You know, this break happened with the Rufus thing. So, I already knew, and then I became the studio drummer in 1974 at Berkeley. So I didn't even know what a click track was. And there was a guy's name was Joe Hostetler. He was the head of the engineering department. They had one studio, and they had a Scully 8-track machine. And the assistant was Doug Getchall, who and I became writing friends and in a band together and stuff. He was down in Florida. And they go, okay, John is my name. You're going to hear these four clicks, and they're going to play this Thad Jones Mel Lewis chart. Just read it top to bottom, and then we'll let you know. So I hear... da, 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 bop. And I play it top to bottom. They go, great. Want another song? I go, yeah. So I started doing all that for school. So I think at that point I realized playing in the studio was fun and easy.
Like that guy you were playing with when you were 11, 12 years old and you knew that you were going to be able to do that. For instance, I remember Paul McCartney years ago saying things like, he said, well, the greatest bands in the world probably never happened. She got pregnant. Dad died. They went off and they left music. Well, for instance, that friend of yours, what did he end up doing? Do you know?
That's a very good question. His name is Kevin Clemons. And I mean, I met him. He was 9. And the guy could play his ass off. Yeah. And then I heard years ago, he had moved to Nashville from maybe Southwest Iowa and became a really good pedal steel player, which is an incredibly difficult axe. And that was the last I'd heard of him.
Wow.
I mean, this kid at age 12 had a 355 Gibson stereo guitar. And I'm thinking, still to this day, you know, I mean, Larry Carlton, 335, but that's like one of the best guitars of all time. You know, think about the things we did. And we won all these talent shows and, you know, and it was just fun. But I don't know. I don't know what happened. I mean, can you imagine if he and I were still together and his growth was like mine?
Make sure you comment on our video, subscribe to our channel, and share our videos. I'm John Beaudin from Rocky Stream Music.